everyone, Cam from Deep Gravity. Well, today had a few issues today, to say the least. I'm standing on a cable here and it's really annoying my foot. Probably should have addressed that before I started pushing record, shouldn't I? Anywho. So today I did a couple of videos. One I did on a chromatic scale, and it was a disaster. Another one I did was on this little guy, which is the Aroma chromatic tuner. And the last video I did was on a project that I was doing. So, the first one, which was the chromatic scale, was a chromatic scale that I've been practicing. And I do it via BPM on a metronome. When I started, I think I started at around about 60 BPM and was incrementally going up and up and up to get better and faster at it. Now, I learnt a chromatic scale 20 years ago, and it was a little bit different to it. The problem I have is that the first time I tried recording it, there was no sound. And I don't know why there was no sound, there was just no sound. I don't think I set it up correctly. So, no sound. Phenomenal. So when I went to edit the video, nada. So I'm like, well, I can do that again, that's fine. The second time I tried recording it, I had done the video, but at that point I'd realized I hadn't plugged the guitar in, so you can't hear the guitar at all. That was fail number two. Fail number three was a project that I've had on the boil for a little while, and I showed you in one of my first videos, and that was to put a new wood print top on a guitar I had, a black guitar, and that is the result. You know, I personally think it looks pretty good. I'm not 100% on the white. I'm not too. I think it looks a bit leery against the wood. Let me know what you think. But all in all, it came off brilliantly, I think. I set up dual cameras to film what I was doing from multiple angles, which was fine. Apparently, I didn't press record. I thought I did, but obviously I didn't press it hard enough and didn't record nothing. Luckily, there is a saving grace. I was taking pictures while I was doing it, so there's probably not quite enough pictures to my liking, but I was just taking them from posterity. So I have a sequence which I can add onto this video to show you what I was actually doing at the time. So it took me, I don't know, about an hour and a half, I suppose, to put the top on, and then I wired it all back up again. Got my soldering iron out, wired the jack up again, and then put some new strings on it. The strings I've got on are super lights. They are sixes, I think, six gauge. So they're very, very thin. I haven't played sixes for a long time. I used to have them on my Samet guitar before I broke tremolo using something that wasn't sixes. The black one over here, I think I've got eights on it, maybe, but they're still pretty thin. But I've never used extra lights before. These are they're nice, but they're very thin. So they are Alice guitar strings. But these are the guitar strings, and Alice is the brand. Professional guitar strings, excuse me. And I bought these from an Australian company called Swamp, which I'm assuming is an agent for Ellis. I've never used Ellis strings before, so they don't seem to be too bad, I guess. They seem reasonable quality, so we'll see how they go. Recently put the strings on, so they're a little bit out of tune. So the first video I was going to do is on this little bad boy, Aroma AT01A, Chromatic Tuner. So with these ones, they're a little one. I was going to buy a Snark, but obviously I didn't. I thought I'd give these ones a go because I'd seen some pretty good reviews on them. So I thought, give it a go. This one was, I think it was around about $11, so it wasn't overly expensive. That's Australian, so it would have been ever cheaper overseas. It's a Chromatic tuner. So basically what that means is you can tune your guitar, number one, or you can also tune the intonation of the guitar, bass, violin, everything like that. So this will actually do, let's switch it on. So at the moment, I don't know if you can see that, it might be a bit glary. There we go, there's the G. So that means it's tuning for guitar, and it's, at the moment it's thinking it's the E string. So it's, it might be trying to tune my voice, I'm not too sure. But what you do is you push this little button down here. That's for a bass, violin, ukulele, or ukulele, whatever you want to say it, and that's the Chromatic. So basically with Chromatic, what that basically means is, if you haven't seen it before, this one. So a Chromatic tuner, basically you play the open string, then you come up to the 12th string, the 12th fret, and it should be, say this is an E, so it should be an E, and then you do a pick harmonic on the 12th fret, and it should also be E. If it's not, then at the bottom here, with the saddle, the bridge saddle, these little screws in here with springs on them, and you can adjust them forward or backwards to let the string out or back, and that adjusts the intonation. So basically what it means is, if that's A, sorry, if that's E, if that wants to be F, F sharp, G. Now if they're not, that means that the intonation is not correct. So the string needs to be adjusted from the rear saddle there. You can also, on guitars like this, you can also adjust the action or the height of the string between the bottom of the string and the top of the fret. So some people like a slightly deeper action so that you have to press down further. I don't, I like quite a low action and easier to play. So Chromatic tuner from Aroma. This is the AT01A. They also do an 101 and 013. I think they might have another one as well at the moment. We don't have access to a lot of the products that Aroma do in Australia. They do drum kits and they do all sorts of different things, and they're actually not a bad brand. It's just a shame we don't have access to a lot of their stuff in Australia. So I thought I'll give it a go. If it's no good, I'll get the Snark. But it works well, keeps everything in tune. The latency on it is probably a little bit more than what you would find with a Snark or some other tuners that are up near the $30 or $40 mark. So, but to be honest with you, for an extra second, I can deal with that. I'm not playing gigs or anything like that. I'm not playing commercially. So if it's going to take me an extra second to tune a string, so be it. I'm not overly worried about it. It's more the accuracy that I'm worried about, and so far as I can see, the accuracy of this is pretty good. The reason why I got one of these, I could always use the tuner on the on GarageBand, or I also have the guitar tuner app. It's T-U-N-A, not T-U-N-E-R. It's guitar tuner. Both of them work well. You can tune my guitars with them. They won't do chromatic tuning though, so I wanted to do some of the intonation on my guitars because they've been hanging around for a while, so I thought it was about time that I did the intonation on it. And this guitar here, this is my shark fin, black. I had this made for me from Rees Guitars in 2000 and I'm going to say 2011. I wanted something a little bit more flamboyant and a little bit more rocky, and I said, what can you make me for a budget? And he said, I can make you anything for a budget, just doesn't mean it's going to be good. So he had bits and pieces for this lying around, the Floyd tremolo. So he had the Floyd tremolo lying around. He had all the knobs and bits and bobs lying around, because he does guitar, he's a luthier, so he makes guitars and repairs them and everything like that. So he had all the bits and bobs lying around, pickups and everything. And the neck to the body, the cavity was obviously the same as they mostly are. And when I saw it, it was great. I thought it was fantastic. It's a beautiful guitar. But I just said, black? Come on, buddy. And he said, well, he did say budget, and I had it in black. If you want it painted, it's going to cost you more. So he did some pretty crazy artwork on his. I might bring up his web. So I'm going to edit all that out. Pete John's clickers. Now, so let's have a look at who built this guitar for me. His name is Cameron. Good fella he is. Okay, so this is his website, Custom Guitar Works. I'm just gonna see if I can. Here's the website. There's his. So he's from Narre Warren, Victoria, Australia, which is where I'm from. Now he does made to order. He also does handmade guitars restoration. Let's see if we can find his. Okay, so you can see here. There you go, Charvel, Ibanez, EVH. So that's not an EVH guitar. That's another brand. And he's just done the EVH Wolfgang Blue Bumblebee custom paint job on it. And there's a Jackson Crackle just here. Let's go back to OBS. Let's see. There we go. There we go. There's some more custom paint jobs. Does some pretty far out stuff. Does some pretty standard stuff. This one here looks pretty awesome. The parts caster, so it's a bit of everything. It's like probably a Charvel or something. There we go, Charvel Samick parts caster. So he's put like a lightning type electricity pattern on it. And right next to that was another parts caster. With a similar sort of motif, except it's red. So that's similar to the red Sammy I've got. Actually, it's not similar, it's exactly the same Sammy as I've got, except it's they've put different pickups in it. And they've got white pickups. Mine's got the traditional Sammy black pickups. Let's see if we can find something a little bit outlandish that he's done. Some nice ones. So there's some of those flying V's that he's done, and there's a shark fin, same as mine, except there's an extra pickup in it. One's only got two doubles. It's got two doubles and a single Mockingbird. When I went there, he had quite a few Mockingbird style guitars, which were pretty nice looking. I was tossing up between the Mockingbird and this type of Gibson copy that I've got. This looking one here, which is a custom build, that's a epic looking guitar. Look at that. Have a look at that, the shape of it. That is awesome. Beautiful hardtail, really eccentric looking looking stuff on it. See some of his handmade stuff. Shall we? See all handmade. So this is some of his handmade stuff. Okay, so this one here was one of his display ones that he had when I went there, which was pretty cool. So it's a murder guitar. yeah, that's pretty cool. I like that. That's not a bad looking guitar at all. Murder Ride, Journey to Danger, Fun for All. And it was glow in the dark. Have a look at this. Glow in the dark. So he painted it with a glow in the dark paint. that's unbelievable. So I'm pretty sure he had this airbrushed, which is, you know, it's a pretty spectacular looking airbrush job. Now, I don't believe he did it himself, but whether he did it himself or not doesn't matter. It looks awesome. See some of the other custom modes. So he had this one as well. He made this one himself. He was, I think he still is actually. He was in a Van Halen cover band, and he made this for himself to play while he was playing in that. Now originally the band was called In Halen. Cover band, and I think him and one other person was the only two left, because the other ones left through work commitments and everything like that. So then they reformed, got some new members, and called it Exhalen. And I believe they're still going to this day. So, but that's a four string bass. He played bass for the band, and that is a pretty unique looking. I believe that's a model after the bass player for Van Halen. Don't quote me on it, I think it is. So there he is there. So that's him playing in the band. That's him and the Eddie Van Halen guitarist from the band on stage. So there's his guitar. There's the, oh, I believe he did the custom job for the guitar that the guitarist there is playing as well. So that's pretty cool. Let's see what else we can find digging around in here. There were some pretty cool looking guitars when I was there. We're going back quite a few years ago now. But he does some absolutely phenomenal job. So these finishes. Here we go. Have a look at some of these. They are absolutely beautiful. When I was there, I went with one of the guys I worked with at the time, and he was looking at a base, and he had this this base there that had the xenomorph airbrushed onto it. Oh, there it is. Mockingbird base with the xenomorph on it. It was absolutely stellar. Have a look at that. That is beautiful. And the guy I worked with wanted to buy this, and unfortunately, it had a sold ticket on it, but that was, have a look at the detail on that. It is absolutely perfect. So that was custom airbrushing on that, and he was selling it for a ridiculous price. It was far too cheap for what it was, but it was an absolute beautiful job, and nicely finished as well. It, what didn't look, there was no orange peel or anything on it. Obviously, someone had an NZ guitar made for their to hang in their business, which is a little bit odd, but you know, takes all types. NZ is a hydraulic hose business in Australia. I don't know if it's overseas as well, but he's cut, I think that's Iron Maiden, isn't it? The Iron Maiden, that's off one of their albums, so they've had that put on the guitar. That looks epic. Fantastic. There's another glow in the dark. That's that's it. Pennywise on there. They all float. That's phenomenal. And glow in the dark. That's great. Have a look at that. So that's not the latest hit. That's Tim Curry. But that's still no less appealing. I think that looks fantastic. Movie poster. That's pretty cool. Well, you can see the quality of his work there. Obviously, he's even encompassed the poster on the pickups as well. Normally, everywhere, because this has got he's put pickup sleeves over. So instead of having the open pickups like you normally have with all the dots in them, he's covered them over and made that look pretty good. Looks like the xenomorph was pretty popular. Look at a little dribble down there. That's funny. Cool. All right, well that's custom guitar works. That's some of his stuff there. So that looks pretty cool. So that's who I got to make this beastie right here. So he did that for me, just out of parts that he has. So I told him that I wanted something that was like a Randy Rhodes type guitar or a Flying V or something like that. So he did the shark fin or the I think they call this a half V or something like that. He also did this one for me as well. custom made on the actual headstock here. He's got his brand name Rees. So I've had a day of thorough mistakes, but at the end of the day it's all turned out alright. I've got the guitar all strung, it's all wired, it works. I'll tune it up and give it a bit more of a play. If you're interested in seeing the chromatic scale, drop a comment down below and I'll do another video on it. But if you got any other comments or ideas, let me know, and I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.